Hello and welcome friends. If you are here and not yet subscribed to this channel, then please subscribe. This is the Chess Learning channel and today I will show you a match that I have played, and it started with e4, e5, c3, nf6, then d4. So the idea is, if the pawn takes, this pawn will sit at the center, or even the queen can take it as per the game demand or the tactical games. So pawn takes, now queen takes. Now knight and queen to e3, pawn, 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 bishop, bishop, knight, black castles. This was a good move from my opponent because the knight is here, bishop is here, fully supported by pawn and the rook. So this is very good, the castle on the king side. Now I also castle on the king side. Now knight is here threatening my bishop, so I will have to move my bishop somewhere, so I move it back. So the pawn moved, pawn moved ahead, and queen to f2. So this is for looking for some attack from the right side and also having a check on the left diagonals, because this is also having a good eye on this. And from black perspective also, the knight is very much good in development and it can be advanced. If it get a support here, it can sit even here threatening this pawn. So these are the things. Now this knight can even come here and can have a check on this square and this square. If it get a support here, it can be the two knight movement are very very dangerous, and always we have to see where the knight will have an attack. So next move was bishop, and so the pawn moved. Now I moved the bishop because in the next step it would have been a forced move, so I moved it here and pawn moved. So this, see the pawn structure this side, so this is very much closed now. So whatever attack I have to make, it have to be from the right side, these two diagonals, three diagonals. Okay, and the knight and supported, this will come later, but the pawn will move, start moving ahead, and it will be supported by the knight or the rook. So next move was pawn takes, then bishop takes the knight. So this was because the idea is, I took the pawn, if pawn takes pawn, then I will take the bishop. So in order to have a safe exchange, my opponent went for this knight. So bishop take knight and queen takes the bishop. So now pawn takes. Now pawn takes again. So here you see I have a pawn up in the game. So now the pawn came, I can even take it, but I supported it because I want a exchange on the rook. So the bishop, pawn takes, I took the rook, queen takes the rook, now I take the pawn. So queen is threatening this bishop. No, it was attacking this pawn and now it is attacking the rook. So it depends upon what my opponent want, because it is also attacking this knight. So one possibility is to move the rook here, but let's see what my opponent was thinking. So he protected the knight, so he missed the rook. So now I can take this rook. Now bishop takes the bishop. So here is the bishop. Knight on the attack, having attack on the bishop, pawn supporting the bishop, but now the knight can take the pawn because it is supported by the queen, and if I take it, then I can take the knight, but I have to give the bishop. So I won't do that. So after the knight takes the pawn, I give a threat to the knight itself. So now knight moved, supporting the queen. So this was a very good move from my opponent. It doesn't even save the knight, but also supported the queen. So I want to trade it out. Then pawn moved, knight moved. Now the game is totally dependent upon the end game. So I have a rook in place of a knight and a pawn up. So this is advantage, but end game, and this is a blitz game, and anything can happen in any time. So I took out the rook for the attack. So I moved the pawn, knight check. So it came here. So now my rook is on attack. So check. Now knight came. I want to take at least one knight so that I can save the time there. Now again check. Moved it up because this pawn was left alone, and if I go here, then again he will check and would like to draw the match. So I supported it. So if he takes, even if it is a check, I can take it. So this is the thing here. So knight moved now, blocking my knight. So he want to give a double check, and after I save my king from the check, he will take my knight. So this was a good move from my opponent. So I moved my rook here to have an attack on this. So if it is a check from here, I will save my king, okay, here or here. And if he takes the knight, I will take the bishop. So this was the attack. Now knight takes knight. I want to get rid of the knight first. So I took the knight. Now bishop is here. Now pawn moved. Pawn moved. So I thought not to exchange it because I have a rook and a knight. So I can have a comfortable game and I can take the pawns later also. So I took the pawn. So I moved the pawn. Now check here. Check here. Now knight went back. So knight is very dangerous at the end game because it controls many sides on the boards. So I want to exchange it. So I brought my knight here, but my partner don't want. He gave a threat to the rook. Rook went back. So this pawn was left isolated and I lost the pawn there. So I want to take the bishop if he moves the knight here. So my opponent see that and he moved the bishop here. So he brought the bishop here. So I moved here. Now I can take the knight. So he took the bishop, I take the knight. Now he takes my two pawns. So this was important. He is thinking that with this three connected pawn, he can push it ahead and win a queen. So this was a good idea actually, but let's see what happens in the game. So I moved my rook. I will plan to move my knight here so that I can take the pawn. So he moved. I did as per the plan. Pawn moved again. Now it is interesting, and so I took it with the rook so that I can have a control over this file, and my king can reach here in two moves. So this is the idea, and with black bishop he cannot support this here. My king can move here in two moves if the pawn goes from here to here in two moves. So my opponent cannot defend this pawn. So next move was king. I moved the king to take this. Now this pawn is undefended. He cannot give a check because rook is here. So he moved the pawn, I took the pawn, king moved, I did a check. So here it is interesting that with one pawn and one bishop, how my opponent is planning the moves. So one move was there, only one move. The bishop came in, I thought of taking the bishop and giving up the rook, and with one knight I wanted to win a queen here also. I can win the queen by moving the king, supporting the pawn, but it will take lot of moves. So what I did, I moved it back so that now bishop is blocked. I want to take this pawn. This pawn is defended by only one piece, so I thought to take it. So king was there and it gave me a chance to take this pawn. Now my opponent cannot defend this pawn. So king here. So this was a good offer for me. I thought to give up these two pieces and take these two pieces. Anyway, I have a winning piece here. So I took the pawn, my opponent took the knight, I took the bishop, my opponent took the pawn. So now in the end game, it is very much important that you should know the mating techniques. So one rook is sufficient to give a checkmate to your opponent, and here you will see how it was possible to checkmate my opponent with a single rook. So this moved, and my opponent will try to have the king at the center so that checkmate can be avoided, but this is the way you can move it down when it is blocked from three side by the king. So keep blocking the king from three sides so that it can be cornered to the last row. So this is how it goes. So the partner king is cornered to the last row, and now this file is already blocked by the king. So if I give a check from here, it will be a checkmate. So that's what happened in the game. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Thank you.